This morning in the kitchen, we are cooking with Thomas Duffy from the Spiced Pear, making some brown sugar cured pork. That just sounds really yummy, especially on a cold day like today.
Yep, it's kind of like making ham at home.
Oh, awesome. I like making ham at home. So speaking of ham, what are the ingredients we're going to be needing this morning?
Well, for our potato cakes, we have roasted sweet potatoes and roasted baked potatoes, some fresh herbs, and some all-purpose flour.
Okay.
Our herbs in here are sage, mint, thyme, and a little bit of fresh chives.
Now, why is mint in there? That's a unique taste.
When you go with the maple syrupy flavor of the pork, the mint adds a really nice sweetness to it, a nice little contrast to the sweetness of the potatoes.
Yeah, mix it up, and it leaves your breath minty fresh.
There you go.
Accomplished
two things at once.
What else?
Then our garnishes are fresh English peas, wild morel mushrooms, thumbelina carrots, some wild ramps, and chive blossoms.
Now, these right here, you said wild ramps.
Yes.
What exactly is this? I mean, it looks a little floppy and...
That's a wild leek.
Wild leek.
From
what does it taste
Michigan.
Like?
An onion.
Oh, very fancy. And these are not from Michigan.
No.
You actually said that these came from your garden
yesterday.
What exactly are they?
That's a chive blossom.
Chive blossom. So the other chives, those green chives, come up from it. And then this is the flower beforehand or
That's
during
That's the
it?
Flower at the end, right before pollination.
And what do you eat? The green part?
You can eat the whole thing.
How about this? I'm going to try this out. Here we go. Wow, that actually has a lot of taste to it.
It has a nice oniony crisp flavor.
And in regards to the meat, what are we going to be looking for with the meat?
We're going to we're going to cure it in brown sugar, this is the cure right here. This is a little bit of brown sugar, white sugar, Chinese five spice, and kosher salt. So what you do is you take your pork and you bury it in the salt for
There's
at least...
one buried right now in there?
No, I haven't buried one yet.
Oh, okay.
And then about three or four hours later, it would come out looking like this. It looks kind of like a raw ham.
Yes.
Then you take that, and there's not enough pork, we would take that and wrap it in a fruitwood smoked bacon.
Ooh, sounds tasty.
Sear it and roast it.
Awesome. Well, we are going to come back. We're going to start mixing all these things. And it's warm inside here, but we actually want to check in and see what the weather's like for all those X Factor hopefuls. How's it going, Michelle? Back in the kitchen this morning with Chef Thomas Duffy from the Spiced Pear making some brown sugar cured pork. You getting excited?
I'm always excited to be here.
I know. I can tell. So what are we going to be doing next?
We're going to make our starch for our pork dish, which is on our Mother's Day menu this year.
Oh, yeah. Well, a lot of people I know, myself included, we still need to make some Mother's Day plans. So tell me a little bit more about, what else is going to be on the menu.
We have a three course for $65. It's an appetizer, entree, dessert.
Awesome.
It varies from a local sea bass to our pork. Want to put about half of that in there?
Tell me a little bit about what's going on here, because I need to...
This is roasted sweet potatoes that we just roasted, peeled off the skin, and pushed through a tammy.
All right.
That's Idaho Baker potatoes that we did the same thing to.
And half of them?
Half of them in there.
All right. You got it.
These are our herbs from our garden. That's sage, mint, thyme, and some chives.
Oh my gosh, they're so fragrant. Smell.
I smell them every day. Give that a good mix, mash it all together.
All right.
You want to make sure you get the potatoes completely incorporated together.
I love that word, incorporated. All right, so what else am I going to be mixing to my incorporated potato herb mix?
We're going to take a couple tablespoons of all-purpose flour. Just mix it in here just so it binds it up a little bit so it won't fall apart. You want to make almost like a stiff pancake batter.
Wow, I'm going to get my arm workout going on here, Thomas. All right, how's this looking?
That's fabulous.
Thank
so
you.
What we would do with this now, you take it, put it in the refrigerator, half an hour, 45 minutes. Might let it set up for a little while. And then this will come out like that.
Looking beautiful. All
right.
Next, I'm ready to scoop.
I'm going to get the oil in the pan first. So you just need a little tiny bit.
Okay.
Kind of just plop it in there and scrape it off with a spoon.
Okay. Just about that size?
Yep.
Awesome. There we go.
Now you're going to let it sizzle at a little crust form. You can put another one in there.
Oh, why not?
Why not?
A little bigger go home, right?
Yep.
Maybe
some snacks. Hungry.
So we're going to let these sizzle and then...
Try to flip it.
I'm going to toss these out, and while I'm doing that, we're going to head on over back to the Dunkin' Donuts Center to see how things are going over there with all the... We are back in the kitchen this morning, cooking things up with Chef Thomas Duffy from the Spiced Pear, making some brown sugar cured pork, and it is getting hot in here, I can tell you that. And now you said we're going to start cooking our garnishes. And I said, oh, what garnishes are those, like the purple flower chive I ate? And he said, no, I call vegetables garnishes.
They look pretty.
They do look pretty, but they're tasty. So let's cook our garnishes up.
All right, first thing we're going to do is get our morels in here. These are going to take the longest.
Now, morels, these are different kinds of mushrooms?
Yes, these
I've
are,
actually never seen these before.
These are actually wild mushrooms from the Oregon and Washington State area.
Mm-hmm.
Maine's really haven't come in yet, so I still have to have them freighted in.
Okay. And where can you buy morel mushrooms?
They carry them at Whole Foods.
Oh,
I buy mine for a distributor out of New York City.
Mm-hmm.
So, but they carry them at Whole Foods.
And do these soak up the oil because they have all those wrinkles in them?
Well, they're kind of a dry mushroom, so you want to kind of like braise them in a little bit of oil.
Okay.
So once that's cooked.
Our thumbelina carrot.
Yes, we got thumbelina carrots here, which is just like a baby organic carrot.
Looks like a mix of a carrot and a strawberry. Do the thumbelina carrots have a different taste to them?
No, they still taste like a carrot.
Huh, easy.
It's just fancy.
It is, it's because it's a garnish.
Garnish it fancy.
So we got the mushrooms, we have the carrots, we have this leek family.
This is a ramp.
Ramp.
So we're just going to throw that in this pan.
Okay, now why a different pan?
Because we're going to fry this one a little bit more.
Oh my gosh, look at it popping right there. Oh God, Thomas, this is going wild. It's like popcorn.
We're going to fry that baby up.
Okay.
Now meanwhile, we have our pork in the oven.
Yes.
This is a fruit wood smoked pork loin.
Beautiful. And how long and at what temperature has that been?
That's 350. It takes about 40 minutes.
Okay, not too bad.
So these are the potato cakes you made.
Yes.
Cute and pretty.
You got it. You know.
So now that this is done, we want to pull these out before they get overcooked. Slide that in there.
Mm-hmm.
Bring off a little bit of this oil here.
It is like popcorn right here.
Turn that one off.
Thanks.
Put our peas in there.
Some spring peas.
Yep. Some fresh thyme.
Perfect. Okay.
Chives. What every dish needs in the world is a little bit of butter.
Amen. Butter makes it better. We love it.
Especially European butter.
That's a lot of butter. That's not a little butter. How much butter did you just put in?
A little bit.
Okay.
I'm French. We use butter.
Yes.
And a little stock. A little vegetable stock.
Okay.
You know, keep it, you know, in the same family as vegetables.
Mixing up. That is looking really good right now.
See, it's pretty.
It is
it's
pretty.
It's a garnish.
Pretty and tasty. Or a dressing. Could you call it a dressing?
You could.
All right.
On one of those plates.
There you go.
So, we're going to take our pork.
Wrapped in bacon.
Wrapped in fruit with smoked bacon. It's a non-cured product, too, so there's no sodiums in it.
What does cured mean?
Cured means the same thing like I did with the sugar and the salt.
Mm-hmm.
You let it sit in there, and you're basically cooking the outside and infusing flavor.
Okay.
So we got our pork here, nice and done.
Oh, I like how you slice it up nice and thin. Beautiful. Take our garnishes with a light buttery spread. And this, as you said, is going to be on your Mother's Day menu.
Yes, this is on our Mother's Day menu.
Okay, and remind our viewers where you're located.
We're at 117 Memorial Boulevard. We're at the beginning of the cliff walk.
Mm-hmm.
Or at the end of the cliff walk, which depends which way you're walking.
Yeah, I mean, and then afterwards, people can go walk off this little breakfast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hopefully it's not raining.
I know. Well, if so, they can
like
wear
today.
A poncho. We're hardy New Englanders.
So we're going to take a little ramp here, put this on top.
That's beautiful.
Take our garnish.
Mm-hmm. Looking good. Those mushrooms.
Put that there.
I'm going to help get these purple chives.
Yeah. Well, actually, I pulled a little bunch out. See
oh,
right there?
Oh, you did.
To make it look pretty.
It does look pretty. I'll sprinkle it. Where do you want me to sprinkle?
You need to wait till I'm... We got a sauce first.
Oh, we're gonna sauce it up. Well, we are gonna have one gorgeous looking meal right here.
Now you can
sprinkle.
Sprinkling
on. Beautiful. You, my friend, are talented. And speaking of talent, we're gonna be checking out things with Michaela over at the Dunkin' Donuts Center.